shoots it, tip just wide, and hit by Buchnevich. Six attackers for St. Louis. Down by one. To the corner for Kyrou. Now back for Thomas.
Now check out the Cards, new Dallas Sports Midwest. That's small.
Right in front.
We get the Cardinals, you won. Get some Marlins.
Into the line for Crew. Tipped. Shin again. Feeds it back to Crew. Winds up. A shot. Tipped wide. Maybe by Neighbors. On the glass. And
oh.
Can't get there. And that should be an icing call.
It will be. Imagine the Blues are going to exercise their timeout.
In the third.
Well, we get an opportunity here for our four-game summary. Tonight's four-game summary, Braden Shen, three-game point streak going, and Nathan McKinnon, 16-game point streak for him. That's a four-game summary. We also have a timeout down here on the ice. Now we circle back to Nico Ranton. He's got such a powerful shot. It doesn't take a lot for him to get that shot off. Obviously a sweet touch there. And then the last one here. Buries this opportunity again. Not much of a wind-up for that shot. And he still ends up putting it behind Jordan Binnington. He's got himself three goals tonight. He's obviously been the main difference maker in the game.
So a timeout here for the Blues. Get to go to the whiteboard and come up with some kind of play. Lots of time to go, but you've got to be very direct, I think, in this situation, Jamie. Just get the puck to the net and just never know what can happen.
Yeah, you got to be very aware of Nathan McKinnon here. He's got such a speed burst that if you're a little too slow, a little lethargic, moving a puck or getting the puck, he's going to be on it quickly. And that's obviously not the guy you want with the puck.
So Shen will take the faceoff against a good buddy of his, Nathan McKinnon. And the Blues win it. And Robert Thomas. That shot tipped. Kyrou gets it back on the goal. Final minute now in the third. As Kyrou waits. Goal line Shen. Now Buchnevich for Crew.
Try to get on your feet, Blue Vets. Here on your Blues.
In front, looking for Neighbors. That's off bodies and wide. And now Shen gets it back for St. Louis. To Buchnevich, a high drive by the year, the goaltender on it in. Now Thomas settles it to the goal line in front. Kyrou can't jam it in. Thomas again. Here's Kyrou again out of the corner. Met by Walker. Thomas recovers it. Blues keep it alive. Buchnevich. And a drive blocked by Nichushkin. 20 left. Blues have to hurry here. Shen back in. Now Neighbors with 10 to go. Centering pass. Block. Kick by Buchnevich. Cleared down the ice, and that's going to do it. Blues have to scamper back. They're going to have a little time. 3.1 left in the third period.
Well, regardless of what happens here, I like that effort by both Braden Shen and Torey Krug. Just burying the needle, trying to get back to make sure that's an icing, and at the same time, keep as much time on the clock as possible.
So 3.1 seconds left. Again, Shen against McKinnon. And the draw one back. Here's Krug.
Oh.
Right on goal, and a save by Onanen. And that'll do it. As the Avalanche get the lone goal in the third from Ranton in his third tonight. And Colorado wins its seventh in a row.
Well, you see the one faceoff there. You know, the goaltender doesn't even really see it until it hits him at the end. This one's a no-brainer. The Hyundai player of the game, Mikko Rantanen, with his seventh career hat trick tonight against the Blues, giving the Colorado Avalanche a 4-3 victory here tonight.
Blues outshot 35-33, and they lose it 4-3. Let's go across to Alexa and Bernie.
All right, John and Jamie, thank you. thank you very much as we welcome you inside our studios here at Enterprise Center. Bernie, you felt like the effort was there from the Blues. Unfortunately, Mikko Rantanen basically had this game in hand himself with his seventh career hat trick. This was a one that the Blues really needed to win, but they put up a good effort against a really tough team.
This would have been a real bonus, no question about it. I mean, the Blues have done a really good job on this homestand, winning three of the four games here. And yes, this would have been bonus points, any point tonight, if they could have got a tie or get it into overtime, even if they'd have lost it in overtime, just to get a point. But they're playing against a really good hockey club, and I think they proved that they could play with them. And I think that is the main thing that they can take out of this. They only got outshot by three shots there. They did a lot of good things. They had good chances. And again, the difference in the game tonight really was the special teams. As the power play was able to score a goal for Colorado, Blues weren't able to get one.
All right. We are going to wrap this one up on CarShield Blues Live. Appreciate you hanging with us tonight in this one as the Avs win their seventh in a row. We'll be back on the other side of the break. We have plenty to talk about in this one. Stay with us, Blues fans, here on Valley Sports.